Ladies and gentlemen, get ready to become hypnotized, mesmerized, or otherwise. He's an award-winning entertainer, certified hypnotist and U.S. Army veteran. Over the past 5 years, he has been pushing the limits of the human mind, entertaining corporate, college, and high school audiences across the country. He's performed well over 1,200 shows and has hypnotized more than 7,000 people. He's a staff sergeant in the South Dakota Army National Guard and has served both Iraq and Kosovo. As a certified hypnotherapist, he has, through personal sessions, helped hundreds in their bid to stop smoking, lose weight, and attain personal goals. He's the director and owner of Kellen Marson Hypnosis Center, located here in Pierre. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together and make some noise for the award-winning comedy hypnotist, Kellen Marson.
Alright, you guys ready to have some fun tonight? Alright, I don't believe you, but we'll get to that point. Because before we get started with the show, we have something special to do tonight. The purpose of this whole show was to raise money for Joe's Pink Bags of Hope. So Joe, do you mind coming up here? Because I have some money to present to you. Give a big round of applause for Joe. Facebook trying to make guesses of how much money we raised. I would have loved to say we raised $8,000 if that gentleman is here. But we didn't get that high, but we did make enough. And Joah, I'd like to present to you $1,256. All right, now you guys ready to have some fun tonight. I'm comedy hypnotist Kellen Marson, and you know, folks, even though I can hardly see through the lights, I can't see enough to know that some of you in this room look a little bit blurry. Don't worry about it, folks. I'm only going to ask for maybe one or two volunteers tonight from every role. So look to your left and look to your right. Who from your party, your friends, your group is going to come up here and become the star of tonight's show? You see, folks, this is where everyone starts pointing at each other. Now, there's a little saying in my business. It says one of the loneliest jobs in entertainment is being a comedian. Ladies and gentlemen, try being a hypnotist without any volunteers. It doesn't work. You see, these chairs, they don't do anything without your butts in them. So by a show of hands, and raise your hands up high, who has never seen my show before? Raise your hands up high if you have never seen my show before. Perfect, got my volunteer. You see, that was easy. Now let me tell you all something about hypnosis. You see, there really is no such thing as hypnosis per se. You see, all hypnosis is the power of suggestion. It's the way that words have to influence us all, the way we think, respond, act, and behave. You see, look at it like this, folks. Every one of you in this room is suggestible. Because if you weren't suggestible, it could mean that you couldn't learn. Nod your heads up and down if you understand. Up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. Perfect. But for some of you, some of you skeptics out here who think they can't be hypnotized, it's better just to show you how easy this is to make work. So everybody put your hands out in front of you just like this. You see, if you don't participate, you make everyone else around you nervous. And then nobody else wants to participate. So if the show tonight stinks, it's your fault. So participate, all right? Put your hands out here in front of you. Now, what's going to happen? As I'm gonna count from 1 to 3, and when I get to 3, we're all gonna clap our hands together on the count of 3. You ready? Focus on me. All right, let's try this one more time. Stick your hands off funny just like this. All right, here we go. 1. I got you again, didn't I? All right, we'll take it serious this time. Here we go now. 1, 2, and 3. Lock your hands together just like this. Take your 2 fingers, put them up in the air just like that. And don't look at me, look directly between your fingers. Squeeze your hands together and watch your fingers begin to pull together as if there's 2 magnets on each tip of your fingers. And you know, some of you resist because I know how this trick works. But focus on your fingers, don't resist, let them move. Let them pull closer and closer and closer and closer. And eventually they will touch because they have to. Now raise your hand if your fingers touch. Excellent, look around. You see, folks, you've all been hypnotized. If you clapped your hands before I said 3, you responded to a visual suggestion. For a brief moment, you were hypnotized. If your fingers touch like this, you use your imagination. You were hypnotized. But there's still some people out here who still think they can't be hypnotized. So let me ask you one question. Where are you? Who thinks they can't be hypnotized? No one's gonna volunteer now. Raise your hand if you think you can't be hypnotized. You see, if you think you can't be hypnotized, I'd like to know how you're still alive. Because you can't wake up in the morning without going through hypnosis first. And you can't go to sleep at night without passing through that state either. But more importantly, who's driven down the highway, the freeway, and zoned out, forgot they drove the last mile? Maybe you blew a stop sign, went through a red light. Raise your hand. I know everybody that has a license has done it. Congratulations, you've all been hypnotized. See, everybody can be hypnotized, whether you think it or not. It's just a matter of whether you want to let me guide you into that state. Now, in just a moment, I'm going to be asking and looking for some volunteers to join me up here on stage. But we got to clear a couple things up first. A lot of people think, because I'm a hypnotist, that I have these special powers. Well, I do. But my powers stop at the limits of your morals, values, and belief systems. So let me tell you this. If some of you have no limits to your morals, values, and belief systems, then I promise you we're going to have a great show tonight. But it is family friendly, so we'll make sure we control that aspect of it. All right? Some people like to volunteer for my show and they have an agenda. And their agenda is to somehow come up here and prove that hypnosis doesn't exist or that they can't be hypnotized. If that's your agenda tonight, I will warn you once. I'm going to find you, I'm going to embarrass you, and I'm still going to hypnotize you. All right, so if that's your agenda, you're in trouble, all right? Now, here's what I want everybody to do. Take your right hand and move it back and forth like this. Now stick your tongue out and move it back and forth really fast. Now everybody's kind of jerk your head a little bit, jerk it around. Now kind of move in your chair. You see, folks, nothing you do on my stage tonight is going to look any more embarrassing than what you were doing just now. So now that we all can get along and everybody's not all shy and worried about what everyone's going to think about them, we can get on with the show. But there is a couple rules. One rule, if you're pregnant, have any type of physical ailments that would prevent you from being able to move around a little bit, all right, probably not the best idea to volunteer for this show. But other than that, if you all lend me your imagination for, say, the next 45 minutes, I promise you, I'm going to return your mind in better condition than before you came up here. But who would be the best volunteers for tonight's show? Well, anybody who wants to be up here. You see, I can't force you into that state. You have to want to be hypnotized. You have to want to experience it. If you don't, it's not going to work for you. So with that said, in a moment, I'm going to count from 1 to 3. And when I get to 3, if you want to volunteer for tonight's show, if you just want to see what hypnosis is like, if you just want to explore your imagination for a little bit, then I want you to come up here and fill these chairs. Now, there's only a few chairs up here. You see, I hypnotize people a little different. You see, in this show, we hypnotize people standing up. So, if there's more than what there is chairs up here, want to volunteer, still come up. All right, not everybody that comes up is going to leave up here on my stage. So here we go, folks. 1, 2, 3, get up here on my stage, let's go. Don't be shy. Now everybody, just put your feet together, put your hands and arms, hang at their sides. gonna happen. From now on, don't talk to anybody, all right? Don't look at anybody, just follow me. Wherever I walk, you move. Nod your heads up and down on the other side. Good. Who's a little bit nervous? You see, people who are nervous, they have a tendency to go into the state quicker and faster, so that's good for me, all right? So here's what's gonna happen. In just a moment, I'm gonna ask all of you to close your eyes. When I do, I'm gonna begin counting down from 5 to 0. With each and every count, you're gonna find that your eyes will become locked, tightly shut. And the only way your eyes are gonna open is when I come up to you, tap you on your forehead like this, just watch and go, then and only then will your eyes open. Nod your head up and down if you understand. Don't let it scare you. Want it to happen, expect it to happen, and watch it happen. Now, look at me now, everybody take in a nice deep breath. And now as you let it out, just let your eyes go closed. Good. Now, I'm just gonna talk to everybody out here in the audience for a moment. But all of you up here, all you need to do right now is just focus on keeping your eyeballs as still as possible. I know it's difficult to focus, but the more you maintain that steadiness, the more relaxed you're going to become. Nod your heads if you understand. Good. Now, everybody out here who is too afraid to come up here, who doesn't like to have fun, all right, you all can still experience this for yourself, okay? All you need to do is follow the instructions that I give them up here, and you can allow yourself to go into that. Now, if you feel yourself or you see someone going into that state, raise your hand like this. I'll come out there and we'll just drag them back up here on stage, all right? See who goes in now. All right, so everyone up here on stage, go ahead and just take a nice deep breath. And throughout this process, you'll find me come by and just kind of push you on your arm a little bit. Don't let it shock you, just let it relax. As you just focus on keeping those eyes as still as possible. Letting those arms hang loose, limp, relax. Now in a moment, I'm going to ask you to raise your right arm in the air. When I do, I'll begin counting from 1 to 3. When I get to 3, I'll ask you to begin slow, lowering your right arm. So go ahead now, take your right arm, put it straight up. Your pointer finger, your index finger, straight to the sky. You're going too fast, you put it straight up in the air. You want it to go slow. Good. And as your arm slowly lowers in your mind, I want you to put a picture, a caption, a person, a place, a thing, a car, a dog, a cat. It doesn't matter. You have an image in your mind. Just nod your head yes and let me know. Good. Now, let that arm slowly lower as you focus on that image. And I'm going to begin counting now from 5 down to 0. And with each count, you'll let those eyelids become tightly closed. You'll let them become so tightly sealed, glued, and locked shut that there's nothing you can do, say, or think that will allow those eyelids to open. Starting at 5, just squeeze your eyes down. Squeeze your eyelids tighter and tighter and tighter and tighter. At 4, your eyelids are locking, gluing, sticking, and sealing, becoming more stuck with each and every breath. At 3, already you're beginning to notice that your eyelids are so sealed and glued and stuck shut. At 2, they're becoming even more tightly closed. At 1, your eyelids have become completely stuck shut. In fact, I bet if you tried and you took this seriously, you'll find that the harder you try to open your eyes, the more tightly closed they're going to become. Don't try it until I tell you to, but all you want to do is just expect it to happen. Watch it happen. Want it to happen. Expect it to happen. And watch it happen. So as you feel your right arm all the way down, all your arms just hanging at your side, as I come by, you just tap your arm, just feel yourself become lighter and lighter. Loose, limp, relax, loose, limp, relax. Deeper and deeper now. Every breath guiding you, taking you deeper and deeper. More and more relaxed. Now, if you're focusing and you are paying attention and you really wanted to experience this state, you'll find that if you try now to open your eyes, they'll just become more stuck. And the harder you try to open them, the more tightly closed your eyelids will become. So try and open them and find they will not work. And if you can't open your eyelids, you put your right hand in the air. If you've really let them become so tightly stuck, they will not open. Put your right hand in the air. Now stop trying to open them and just put your hand in the air. You see, it just doesn't work. Your eyelids have become so relaxed now that it's easier just to keep them closed than it is to open them. Right? So the person I'm touching now, just tell me how your eyes feel. You can't open them, can you? Good. Have a seat behind you. There's a chair right there. Just have a seat. Keep those eyes closed. Good. Now, just lean back. Sit nice and straight. And I'm just going to pick up your right arm, and when I drop it, just feel yourself just stuck to the chin. Just glue stuck to the chin. And you just go deeper. And deeper, and deeper. That person I'm touching now, tell me how your eyes feel. If they're what? They're closed. Are they tight? Try and open them. Find them. Work it. They're stuck. Good. Now, put your arm out. And I'll just lean into me. I have you. Just lean. I got you. Now just feel your knees buckle. I got you. I can't set you down. You're fine. Just sleep. Melt. Watch this. Just sleep. Relax. How do your eyes feel, bud? They're good? Try and open them. Are they stuck? Do they want to? Let them close. For the first time touching now, how do your eyes feel? They're stuck? Good. I want you to take a couple steps forward. There you go. A little bit more. Alright, now when I touch you on your forehead, your eyes open. Wow, crazy, huh? Did you think that would work for you? Good, close your eyes again. Take a deep breath and let your eyes become stuck shut. Try and open them and find they will not work. Now, when I touch you on your shoulder, I have you. Just feel yourself lean into me. Just 5 times deeper. And just feel your knees behind. I have you. Just let yourself go. I've got you. Just sleep. All the way down. Just. So the person I'm touching now, how do your eyes feel? Heavy? Good. Take 2 steps back. I'm going to guide you. Had a seat right there. Sit down. Now this looks more violent than what it is, folks. Sit back. All right. Take your hand. Push your hand down on mine. Push your hand down harder and harder. Even harder. Put a lot of pressure on it. A lot of questions. Just sleep. Just melt. Just go deeper and deeper. Deeper and deeper. So the person I'm touching now, hold your eyes here. Stop. And when I touch you on your shoulder, just let yourself melt in. Just sleep. Just melt. Just good. Stand back up and have a seat behind you. You're good. There you go. Now, and take your hand for a minute, push down on mine, push down, harder and harder, really hard. See, I push up, you push down. On the count of three, I push up, you push down. 1, 2, 3, sleep! Just sleep, just melt. And I'm just going to lean you this way a little bit, just sleep. Just sleep. For the first time touching now, what do you always feel? You're heavy? Good, have a seat behind you, just take a couple steps back. Oh, just sit down. There you go. Just sit. Just sleep. You can go back. Thank you. Yep, you can go back. You're fine. The first time touching now, how do your eyes feel? They're closed? Try and open them. Alright, let your eyes go closed. Now, put your feet together. Don't move your feet. Just let me fall into me. Don't move your feet. So you do good, see? Good. Now, just feel yourself falling back. Good. Now, slightly begin to bend your knees. And watch as the weight of your body pulls you down. As you go deeper and deeper. You can try to resist, but the knees just pull down more and more. And the more you resist, the more your knees drop, and you'll find that eventually you're going to lay on the floor and go very deeply into that state. Don't resist. First time touching now. Out of your eyes. Good. Take one small step behind you and have a seat on the chair. See? Now, when I push your arm down, see, nice and comfy, you just let that arm drop and touch it. Just melt. Just sleep. Deeper and deeper and deeper. Sleep! For the first time touching now, how do your eyes feel? You don't know? Try and open your eyes. Alright, you want to try something cool? It's cool. Walk with me. Alright. Stand right there. Put your feet together. Alright? You can let your arms hang. Just let them hang. Don't resist. Just let them hang. Now look at them. Just stare at them. Okay? Don't look away. This is going to be fun for you. Look at me. Look this way. Look this way. Look this way. Look at me. Look this way. Look this way. Look this way. Look at me. Look this way. Sleep! Just sleep! Just sleep! Just melt! Just sleep. You're good. Get out. Some people like to come up with an agenda. You're good. You can go. I scared you, didn't I? I told you I was going to embarrass you. The person touching now, how do your eyes feel? Okay, try and open your eyes. Alright, let the hook close. Really try to let the feet stop. Can you feel yourself just leaning into it? Don't resist. Just let your whole body move. I've got you. Just feel your knees buckle. Just bow. Just lay down. Just relax. To the person I'm touching now, how do your eyes feel? Close. Try and open your eyes. Alright, have a seat right back here. And you just continue to go deeper and deeper. Folks, usually we don't have this many people, so it'll take a sec, but we'll get them all in here, as many as we can. You can go through. Put your hand on my hand. Push down on my hand, okay? Now blink. Blink again. Blink one more time. Now let your eyes go close. Push down on my hand. When I put my hand up, just feel your body melt. Even now, you can feel just melt. Deeper and deeper. Just leave you this way. Take a deep breath, and as I rock your arm, just feel your body. Just feel yourself sinking. Going deeper, and deeper, and deeper. Just feel yourself. Alright, go ahead and share behind you, okay? And how are your eyes? like, I don't think I'm stuck. Walk back with me. Walk, 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 walk. Have a chair right there. Sit down. And now just melt. Just sleep. Be even comfortable. Take your hand, sweetheart. Sit up straight. Look at me. Look at me. Close your eyes. Close them. All right, sweetheart. I'm going to have you go back to the audience, okay? Thank you, though. To the person I'm touching now, how do your eyes feel? It's ridiculous, isn't it? You didn't think it would work for you. Nobody ever does, though. All right, take a couple steps forward. Turn this way. Now, just feel yourself lean into me. Don't resist, just feel it. I got you. Don't move your feet. You see, I got you. Now, stand back up firm on your feet. And now, put your feet together. And I'm thinking about your knees for a moment. And feel your knees buckling. Feel yourself melting to the floor, drifting. And you'll fall steadily and easily onto the floor as you just feel yourself going deeper and deeper. Just melting. I got you. Just melting. Just sleep. Just sleep. Just sleep. Just sleep. Just sleep. Now, even deeper. Deeper and deeper and deeper. First time touching down. Just feel yourself fall back in your knees. Sleep, just sleep. Just sleep. Just don't resist. Just sleep. Just sleep. Let your arm hang. Do this one for your eyes. Alright, I'm gonna have you go back out there, okay? Thank you though. All my volunteers up here on stage, in a moment I'm gonna begin counting from 5 down to 0. With each count, I just want you to begin to double this feeling in your body and in your mind. So that when I get down to 0, you'll find yourself 5 times deeper and 5 times more relaxed than you are now. Starting at 5, becoming aware now of how your mind is floating in and then out of my voice. At 4, your arms and legs are becoming heavier and heavier. At 3, you're just melting, sinking, floating, drifting, just even deeper now with each breath. At 2, you're becoming even more relaxed. 1, just letting go, allowing the sound of my voice to guide you as it takes you deeper and deeper and deeper. Now, from this moment on, anytime I suggest the words deep sleep for the purpose of hypnosis, you'll just allow yourself to enter this state quickly, calmly, and deeply. The physical body and the mind will relax and you'll go even deeper. And every suggestion I give you from this moment on will become your complete and total reality the moment that I say it, no matter how ridiculous or strange it may be. Nod your head if you understand. Up, down, up, down, up, down. Good. As you go deeper and deeper, just sleeping now, melting, floating, sinking and drifting. Now, in a moment, I'm going to count from 1 to 3. And when I get to 3, you're no longer here in Pierre, South Dakota. In fact, you're chilling on a beach in Jamaica. It's so nice and warm. The temperature is fantastic. On the count of 3, your eyes will be closed, but you just lean on back. You stretch out and you just enjoy that warm heat beating down on your body. Nod your head if you understand. Good. 1, 2, and 3. Stretch on back and feel that sun. Take it in. Wow. 85 degrees and getting warm. Oh, enjoy it. Oh, we're getting up now. It's getting even more. 90 degrees is getting hotter. Fan yourself, it's so hot. Oh, it's so hot. If I touch you on your shoulder, you just fan yourself more and more and more and more. Oh, it's so unbelievably hot. We're getting up to 100 degrees, it's getting warmer. You can go back. Thank you. 105, getting warmer. 110, reach under your chair next to you. There's some suntan lotion. Put that suntan lotion on. Oh, ladder up. It's getting warmer. 120 degrees. Getting warmer, yes. And uh-oh, You just saw someone of the opposite gender walking by and it's beautiful. Why? Oh, look at that. Amazing. Amazing. Now we're getting up to 150 degrees. It is so, so hot. Getting hotter yet, but don't worry about it. Because now it's changing and you're finding yourself on the Arctic Circle. And it's 30 degrees and getting colder yet. I bet if you find someone on the floor, they're going to warm you up. Find someone next to you, they'll warm you up because it's negative 5 degrees now. Find someone to cuddle up with, they're going to warm you up. Negative 10, it's getting colder. The minute you smell it, the only way that smell will go away is if you get yourself on a chair. Nod your head if you understand. Good. 1, 2, and 3. Oh, take a whiff. Get a chair. The only way it's going away is if you sit your butt on a chair. Seriously, we got your chair right here. Find a chair. Get yourself on a chair. Oh, and the smell goes away. The smell goes away. Right here. I got you. Open your eyes. Right here. Have a chair. There you go. Oh, the smell is gone. Slide over there. And now, just close your eyes. Stuck to the chair like glue. Just sleep. Stuck to the chair like glue. Because now you realize that horrible smell is actually coming from you. 1, 2, and 3. Oh, wow, smell that. It is you that smells. Oh my word. If I touch you on the shoulder, you smell worse and 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 worse. What's going on over here? Terrible, huh? Oh, jeez. Wow. You okay? Oh, Greeks, huh? Well, let me make it better for you, because now you realize you're beginning to smell an amazing smell. That amazing smell is coming from the person to your left or right. You just want to lean in there and take a nice whiff of them, because they smell so wonderful. Oh, it smells amazing. Just take a nice whiff. Get close, really good, because it's 10 times better smelling. The harder you try to resist it, the better it smells. It smells amazing. Oh, it smells just wonderful. Getting even stronger now. It smells better and better. Oh, it smells absolutely wonderful. And now, just sit up nice and tall in your chair. Stuck to your chair, just sleep now. Alright, give my big, I guess my volunteers up here tonight, a big round of applause, and a lot of them got the people who go. In just a moment, when I count from 1 to 3, you're going to realize that you're at the dentist, but that dentist has left, and you have free reign to the laughing gas machine. So on the count of 3, you're going to take your shoe off because that's your laughing gas machine. You're going to pass and take a whiff. Oh, you just start laughing. You can't resist. The more you take in, the funnier it gets. Every time I touch you on the shoulder, you laugh more and 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 more. Now a deep laugh, deep man laugh. Now a high-pitched laugh. And just keep taking it in. How about you keep this high the entire night? You can have it all you want. It's a nice healthy buzz for you. Take it in even more, just take it in. Just enjoy it, because now you realize that your shoe is now a little puppy. Oh, it's so cute. Give that puppy lots of kisses, cuddle with it. Love your puppy, give it lots of hugs and kisses. Enjoy that little puppy. Oh, it's so cute. But you just realized that puppy crapped all over you. Oh. Oh man, it's everywhere. Don't throw the puppy. Oh, it's everywhere. It's everywhere. It's everywhere. Now, who is she with? Just sit up in your chair. I've got you. Just sit up in your chair. Just sit up in your chair. You have an interesting thing with smells. I don't know if it's the dog or the shoe, though. To all my volunteers up here on stage, just keep going deeper and deeper and deeper. And one more time, audience, give a big round of applause for the people. Okay, just a more and more and more. This looks terrible, I know. In just a moment, to my volunteers up here on stage, you're going to open your eyes on the count of 3, and you're going to realize that you just robbed the bank. And in front of you is a bunch of money. You take that money and you hide that money so you can't get caught. All of you can legally drive. You're going to get into your Ferrari and you're going to drive away once you gather this money. You're going to drive as fast as you absolutely can, getting as far away as fast as you can from that bank. Nod your head if you understand. Up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. On the count of 3, you'll open your eyes and see money in front of you. You will grab that money. You will jump into your car, which is on your chair, and you will drive away as fast as you can. 1, 2, and 3. Is gonna get away. Good evening, sir.
Hey.
What are you doing?
Going to the grocery
At 150 miles an hour. You have any money on you? None whatsoever. We're going to find out. Little man, are you even old enough to drive? Where were you heading to? Your house? But do you have money on you? Do you? You're honest. You're always honest with that. Ma'am, what's your problem? You heading to the hospital? Why were you going to the hospital? Buddy, what in the world?
It's my cousin's wedding.
Do you have any money on you?
No, sir.
We're going to find out. Buddy, really, can you reach the gas?
Yeah.
What are you doing? Going to McDonald's. You may get away with this. Sir, what was the problem here?
I was talking to you.
At 150 miles an hour in Ferrari. Catching fire. Do you have any money on you?
Just money getting moved.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Positive. Mm-hmm. All right. Ma'am, what's your problem? Are you okay now? Are you still holding that? Do you have money on you? No? None at all? Okay. Ma'am. What happened? You're going to Disney World. From Pierce, South Dakota in a Ferrari. Going 150 miles an hour. Let me ask you something. Do you have any money on you? None? No money whatsoever? Let's find out. Should we find out if they have money on them?
Yeah!
Sit up in your chairs. Close your eyes. Stuck to your chairs. Sit back. Close your eyes and just sleep. Just stuck to your chair. Just sleep. Deeper and deeper and deeper and deeper. In just a moment, you're going to hear a song play. When you hear this song, the instant you hear this song, right here, that money is going to become really hot. It's going to get hotter and hotter. And you're going to begin throwing that money out. And when you can't take it anymore because that money's so hot, you're going to stand up at the top of your lungs and you're going to scream, "I robbed a bank!" as loud as you possibly can when you're ready to turn that heat off. Nod your head if you understand. Here we go now. 1, 2, and 3. It's getting warmer. It's getting hotter. Even if you throw the money, you're still getting warmer. The only way that heat comes off is if you admit to what you just did. It's getting hotter. How long can you hang on?
I'm off the bank!
So it's gonna go down, it's getting hotter.
I
took 200
shots. I'm out of the
bag!
I'm out of the bag! 100 times hotter. You're fighting me, don't you? Now, when I took you on your show, will you realize it's just time to admit what you did? Have a seat. Have a seat. Right here. It's like it. It's like it. I'm sorry. Everybody have a seat. Everybody sit down. Everybody sit down. Just melt down deeper and deeper and deeper. Where's Joah? You want to have some fun with your brother? Come here. Come on, volunteers up here. A big round of applause. All you got to do is I'm telling you, okay? So I'm going to volunteer up here on stage. In just a moment, you're going to open your eyes. Actually, you probably would come up here and just kneel because the light's kind of bright. You're going to see Joel holding a sock monkey. Whatever that sock monkey does, you do. If she shakes it, you shake. If she makes it roll, you roll. It's like an extension of your body. You won't hit anybody. You won't bump into anybody. Nod your head if you understand. Whatever she makes that sock monkey do, you're going to do. Nod your head if you understand. Are you ready for this, Joel? 1, 2, and 3. Eyes open. Sit up. Make a jump. Make a jump. Up and down. Drop it on the floor. make it roll. Easy on the edge of the stage. All right. Sit right here on the edge. Just your feet over just a little bit. And just watch it. Just watch it. Just watch it. Just watch it. Give a big round of applause. The person I'm touching now, I'm going to put a microphone in your hand. Hold on a minute. In just a moment, to the person who's holding the microphone, you have just become the one and only Shania Twain. You don't even need to know the lyrics to this song because you just sing it. It just happens. It's just natural to you, not your head if you understand. You're going to get up, and these are all your fans, hundreds of thousands of them here, to see you perform. Not your head if you understand. Good, so on the count of three, you're gonna stand up and these are gonna be all your fans. But everybody else, you are her backup dancers and singers. You're all gonna get behind her and you're gonna support her. You're all gonna dance and sing with her. But Shania, you'll be in the front because this is your show. Everybody nod your head if you understand. Good, one, two, and three. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome Shania Twain to the stage. Thank you. And just feel yourself sitting up nice and straight in your chair. Just look at me, stuck to your chair, just sleep! Go deeper and deeper and deeper and deeper. Joah, you'll want to take a picture of this one. To all my males on stage, in just a moment, you have just become beautiful and luscious runway models. You are going to walk that catwalk. You are going to be the sexiest man alive. You can't even resist it because you know the one who walks that catwalk the best is going to win $1 million. Nod your head if you understand. To my males only. To my males only, on the count of three, you're going to stand up. You're going to go to the right of the stage, and you're each going to take a turn walking the catwalk for $1 million. Nod your head if you understand. Good. One, two, and three. Males, eyes open, just sleep. Come over here, gentlemen, come over here. Right here, who goes first? You got this, Dylan? $1 million, buddy. Go get him! Work it. Somebody get it. The more noise you make, the more you make my match. Sit up, everybody. Go get it. Goes fast and slow, slow and fast, really fast and normal. Keep up with the beat of the music. You are rock stars. $1 million prize. Nod your head if you understand. Up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. You are amazing Macarena dancers. On the count of three, you'll walk to the center of the stage, and when you hear the music begin playing, you're gonna show us what you got. One, two, and three. Go to the center of the stage, ladies and gentlemen, give a big round of applause for our Macarena dancers. Here we go. Keep up! Quite awake, with no memory of what just happened. What are you guys doing? What are you guys doing? I'm trying to do a show, you know what? Just sit down, except you, Dylan. Come here, I've got something for you. All of you just sit down and just go deeper, deeper. Close your eyes. Steady on your feet. Sweet. Steady on your feet. Just sleep. You see, I got this balloon here. Compliments of Melvin's Flower Shop. I'm going to put this on your shoulder. Dylan, in a moment, you're going to look up and you're going to see the creepiest guy you've ever seen. The guy just follows you everywhere. Wherever you walk, he's just there. You don't know why, but he's freaking you out. You can't touch him. You can't hit him. He's just there. And you try to get away from him. You can try to get out the stage. You can run around, whatever you gotta do. But he just won't go away. He's just this creepy man on you. Nod your head if you understand. Good. 1, 2, and 3. Here, I have something better because now it's a beautiful woman following you. She is hooked to you. Now, watch this. Come here, Dylan. When I take this off, it's like I just ripped off a part of you and you just become so sad. Oh, it's so sad. So sad. And all my volunteers, in a moment when I snap my fingers, you're watching the saddest movie you've ever seen. 1, 2, and 3. Sit up in your chair and see that sad movie, Dylan. Have a chair and watch that sad movie. Oh, it's so sad. It's the saddest movie you've ever seen. 10 times more sad than Old Yeller. Oh, it's so, so sad. It's getting even sadder. Oh, it's so sad. Oh, my word. Oh, don't hit the puppy. Oh, geez, oh, the puppy. Oh, my word, that poor puppy. Oh. But now the movie's beginning to change. The movie's beginning to change, and it's a scary movie because there's a surfer, and he's being chased by a shark now. Uh-oh. Oh no. Oh my word, he's gonna get it. He's gonna get it. Uh-oh. Oh no, he's getting closer and closer and closer and closer and closer. Uh-oh. Funnier, more funny. You don't even know why you're laughing, you just are. It's just so freaking funny. More. And of course I'm touching out every time I saw my foot, a rat just ran under your chair. The person I'm touching now, every time I stop my foot, you think the person to your left just pinched your butt. She doesn't actually do it, it just feels like it. And you continue to see that red every time I stomp my foot. And you think the person to your left passed gas whenever I stomp my foot. And when I stomp my foot again, it's 100 times more powerful. Oh. What's going on right here? Now you can hear it. Now it's on your leg. Now it's up your pants. Go up the back of your shirt. You want some help? Now it's on your head. Get it off, 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 get it off. Get it off. You got some long arms. Now you can hear it and you think it's funny. Watch out for that. All right, all of you, come here for a minute. Everybody stand in the center of the stage. Stand in the center of the stage. Right here, everybody stand right here. Right here, right here. Just make a circle. Just really make a circle. Just make a circle. No, not with your arms. Just make a circle. Gather around. Now. When I stop my foot, that suggestion I gave you is gone. From now on, when I stop my foot, you feel like you're being attacked by mosquitoes. And now, for the six-year-old that's out here, all my volunteers on stage, you are now the meanest dinosaurs ever. Where's that little boy? Is he out here? He's over there. And now freeze! And you just realize you have a wedgie. Uh-oh! Get it out! Get your wedgie out! Oh, it burns! It hurts! It pains! Get out! Ow, 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 ow! Freeze! Freeze, freeze, freeze. Now everybody move forward. Everybody move forward. Find a space. Find your own space. Find your own space. And here's what I want you to do. Be firm on your feet, steady on your feet, away from chairs, away from bumping anybody, and just begin to feel yourself melting to the floor. Feel yourself, your eyes closing, beginning to enter right back into that state. You won't just fall, you'll guide yourself down, but you just feel yourself melting. Just melting. Just sinking. And as soon as you hit the floor, you go right back into that state. Deeper and deeper and deeper. Just feel yourself sinking. Floating. Just melting. All the way down. Deeper and deeper and deeper and deeper. And deeper and deeper. And just sleep. Deeper and deeper. Almost there. Almost there. Almost. Sleep. Oh, just sleep. Do you guys have fun tonight? Yeah. Yeah. Come on back here, look, we're on stage. I'm going to give you all something special for having volunteered tonight. So I want all of you on the count of three to find yourself a chair. Find yourself a nice, comfy chair. Sit nice and straight in that chair with your feet flat on the floor and your hands on your knees. Nod your head if you understand. Good. 1, 2, and 3. Find yourself a chair. Find yourself a chair. Sit up nice and straight. Sit up nice and straight. Nice and straight. Now, give a volunteer a big round of applause. You guys can go right back to the last place. To the chair, going deeper and deeper. Now, as many people know, I'm also a certified hypnotherapist. And one of my beliefs is that you never waste a good state. When someone's in this state, it's this state that allows you to make changes in your life. You cannot make change unless you pass through this state first. It happens here. And because they lent me their imagination, I'm going to send them back out here better than when they came up here. Now, everyone, regardless of age, has something maybe they want to improve in their life. Maybe they want to get better grades. Maybe they just want to feel more confident, have better self-esteem. Whatever it is that you'd like to improve on in your life, I'm going to give you that chance now. So in your mind, pick something you'd like to improve on. And when you have it in your mind, you nod your head up and down. Good, good. You just find something you want to work on. Maybe you just want to have better grades in school, focus better. It doesn't matter, you see. It all starts in your subconscious mind. Now, I'm going to count from 1 to 5. With each and every count, you're going to find that you're going to begin to feel whatever it is you want to change about you. It just begins to go through your body. You don't tell anybody what you're focusing on. It belongs to you. But this is how you begin manifesting those things in your life. So focus on your right arm now. And as each and every count, you begin to feel it. It's not enough to want it. You have to expect you can have it, believe you can have it, and feel it. Starting at 1, begin to feel that right arm becoming lighter and lighter. Feel whatever it is you're focusing on building inside your arm. 2, it's becoming even lighter, that feeling building. It growing stronger and stronger and stronger, and it's building in you. 3, becoming lighter and lighter and lighter. The whole right arm just beginning to lift and rise. Lighter and lighter and lighter. Lifting and rising. Floating and jerking. Every breath you take, you begin to feel whatever it is you're focusing on. You see, all you have to do is want it. You have to actually feel like you already have it. If you can do that, you can accomplish anything. I've been there. Focus on it. Feel it. Expect it to happen. Want it to happen. Watch it happen, but more importantly, feel it build now. Feel it becoming stronger and stronger with every breath. Feel it flowing through your veins. You're manifesting it. This is where change happens. Focus on it as that right arm lifts higher and higher. Focus on it. See it, you've already got it. See yourself sitting in class, studying, feeling like the information is just pouring into your brain so easily and effortlessly. You want to make more money. You have to believe you already have it. You can't do it unless you believe and feel it. Now on the count of 5, on the next count when I snap my fingers, your right arm is going to drop down, loose, slip, and relax. You're going to go even deeper. And you're going to find that you can go into this state whenever you want on your terms. And all you've got to do is imagine you're looking and watching a movie in your mind on a screen. And you see yourself having whatever it is that you want in your life. Nod your head if you understand. Good. So here we go now. And 5, just melt down and go deeper and deeper and deeper and deeper. Now, in a moment, I'm going to begin counting from 0 to 5. When I get to 5, you're going to open your eyes, but not before 5. When I get to 5, your eyes will open. You will have no idea what you did up here tonight until you take 3 steps. On the 3rd step, it's all going to come back to you. Everything you did is going to be right back there. And you're going to be blown away because you can't believe what you did up here tonight. And any time from this moment forward, that anybody, whether it's myself or anybody in the audience, says my name, Kellen Marson, you're going to stand up at the top of your lungs and you're going to scream, he's the man. Nod your head if you understand. Up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. And whatever it is that you're focusing on, you can focus on it. You don't have to tell anybody about it. You own it. It's a part of you. Build it and form it and mold it and bring it to a reality. Here we go now. At 1, you find yourself becoming more and more alert. At 2, you're beginning to sit up, the eyes still closed. 3, you're feeling better and better. At 4, getting that feeling back now in your hands, your arms, your legs, your feet. On the next count, your eyes will pop open. The audience is going to give you one heck of a round of applause because you've all been such fantastic volunteers tonight. Here we go. And 5, eyes open, wide awake. Ladies and gentlemen, my name is John Larson. Did you guys have fun tonight? You don't like John Larson?
He's the man.
There we go. Now we're being someplace. All right, Kellen Larson, I hope you all had fun.
Yeah.
Power of suggestion. I'll drive safe tonight. I have another show to get to, but I will be here for a few more minutes if anyone has any questions. Other than that, thank you. Joah, keep doing what you're doing, okay? I hope you had fun tonight. Keep up the good work. Thank you, Joah. Good to meet you. You guys all see the show. You guys wondering what happened now, aren't you? How do you feel? You feel like a retard? What? Yeah. But, someone had a bracelet of PG. There you are. All right, guys, that's all I got for you tonight. Have a wonderful night. Thank you.